It baffles me how I could have gone so long without ever unboxing an Antech 300. So here we are today. It's not a new product by any stretch of the imagination, but we have the Antech 300. It is SSD hard drive compatible, which it wasn't when it was first released. This is a fairly old SKU, but still very popular. And okay, so they're calling it a versatile mini tower. You know, like I even featured it in a in an airflow optimization guide a while back. I just must have, maybe I shot an unboxing and never actually uploaded it. Either way, picture of the case on the side, filtered front panel takes in air efficiently and prevents dust buildup. That's good. Okay, we've got our features and specs on the side here, and let's just go ahead and start getting this open. So the Antech 300, if you go to any kind of a LAN party, there's a couple cases that you're gonna see just a ton of. You're gonna see a ton of 900s, you're gonna see a ton of 300s. This is a very, very common case because it provides you gamer type features such as optimized airflow, mesh fronts at a price point that is very, very attractive. All right, so the first thing we find when we open up the box is Antech's characteristically excellent packaging. Here you go. So you can see they're using a closed cell foam that is going to protect your case from any damage that could potentially occur in transit. So we've got a good inch plus of foam on all sides of the chassis. Very, very nice to see that. We've got some documentation in here, including a user's manual. And yeah, this should give you some idea how old the box design is. Despite its eminently portable frame, the 300 has enough room for an NVIDIA 8800 series graphics card. How impressive! We're up to the GTX 500 series at this point, so we're several generations away from when an NVIDIA 8800 series was a concern whether it would fit in your case or not. It goes to show you that the development cycles for cases are not quite as fast as they are for graphics cards, nor do they need to be. If you have a well-featured, classic-looking case, then you don't really need to redo it for quite some time. All right, here it is, the 300. So you find, first of all, the mesh front. You've got three 5 1/4 inch bays, and then you have dual 120 millimeter intakes in the front of the case. So these are filtered intakes. Although I'm not actually sure how the filters come out for this particular one. It does not come preloaded with fans there, but at least it does give you the option of adding them so that you have airflow going directly over your graphics cards, or graphics card, I guess if you don't run two, which most people don't, from the front of the chassis. Nice thumb screws, those nice wide thumb screws, so it's easier to get a grip on them than the smaller head thumb screws. We're gonna take the side panels off. So the side panels use a pretty standard finish. It's not quite that super matte finish, but it's also not glossy. So it's gonna be fairly fingerprint resistant, but not perfect. I mean, if you keep your case reasonably clean, it's not really a concern. On the side, you can see we've got a punch out for a 120 millimeter fan. So that's gonna blow directly over your graphics card. So it's all about graphics card cooling. The way I would probably set this case up for optimal cooling would be two 120 millimeters as intakes in the front. And then I would set this one right here up as an exhaust, because most cards these days, I mean, it depends what you're using, but if you have an NVIDIA reference card, for example, it's gonna be drawing air in on this side and kicking it out on this side. So you wanna help it rather than work against it. So let's look at the inside of the case. As you can see, it's a fairly basic chassis in terms of its construction. We've got one, two, three, four, five, six, five, 3 1/2 inch drive bays. We have our SSD mount here at the bottom. So you can see they've retrofitted it with that. So you're just gonna screw these in from the bottom. You can mount one SSD here and it can still support its full complement of 3 1/2 inch drives, even if you do that. There are the mounts for your 5 1/4 inch. So there's no toolless stuff going on in this chassis. It's very basic. I mean, toolless, if you're only going to build the system once, isn't that big of a deal. It's only if you're doing frequent modding, you're going to want to consider maybe getting a higher end chassis, such as the 900, which uses thumb screws to mount the drives, for example. All right, here we've got our motherboard tray, which features a nice big cutout. So no matter where your motherboard positions the CPU socket, you shouldn't have any problems swapping out a CPU cooler, even if you have a backplate on the back of it, so you can just take that off and you don't have to take out the motherboard or anything like that. Here's power for our top 40 millimeter fan. We've got all of our front leads for the front power switch, front lights. Actually, what do we have on the front of this case? Let's have a look. So we have two front USB 2 ports. We have a microphone port, headphone port, and a power switch. Oh, okay, there's a reset switch in there, so it's hard to hit by accident. That's a really thoughtful feature, actually. All right, motherboard mount. You've got room for your standard ATX motherboards. You're not going to get much longer, you're not going to get much wider. It's got your standard 7 PCI slots. Bottom-mounted power supply. This is one of the first value chassis that did offer the feature of the bottom-mounted power supply. Remember, Entek did pioneer that with the P180, at least on the mainstream. I mean, there's always a modder who's done it before someone else, but they were the first ones who brought a mass production case to market with a bottom-mounted power supply. Okay, we've got a 120mm fan in the back that comes pre-populated with a 120mm fan. This is one of their Tri-Cool fans, so you can set it to low, medium, or high. The one on top is actually not a Tri-Cool, so that one runs at full speed regardless. So the total fans that you can populate in this case are 140 up in the top, 120 in the back, and then two more 120s in the front as intakes. All right. In terms of accessories, there's not a whole lot going on here. This is our entire accessory box. Thumb screws, other screws. That's it. So if you want, you know, fancy add-ons, then look elsewhere, I suppose. Cable management. So we've got little zip ties back here for managing cables on the side of the drive cage. So this will allow you to hide your cables if you're using a non-modular power supply. You can just bundle them all up here, tie them down, and that would probably be the best way to go about that. So I think that's pretty much all I have to say about the 300. I don't think I ever showed a view from the back, so that's what it looks like. If you haven't seen one before, don't forget to subscribe to Linus Tech Tips for more unboxings, reviews, and other computer videos.